And Meg Storms joins us now with sports. And for the third, this is the third time in 11 years that the Brier Final won't have a team from Alberta. Sad day for Alberta, hey?
It is a sad day. They may be stuck playing for the bronze, but the silver lining is that Mark Kennedy gets to come home and hopefully see his second child born. Here's how it played out today. The winner would move on to the semifinal versus Newfoundland, and Martin was hoping to mimic Kevin Cooey last year, who won the Brier out of the 3-4. Martin had the choice of rocks and hammer, but all he mustered in the first was this, a chance to score a couple. But the angle is just off, and Alberta lucky to sneak in a single. Tied at one in the fifth now, and here's where all that training in the gym pays off for Kennedy and Hebert. Martin, a little bit light out of the hack, and he is all over the front end to sweep like banshees. I'm sure they really love their skip at this point. As for Howard, final stone, he'll tap back the counter, and that's a deuce. Ontario is now up 3-2 at the midpoint. Alberta would blank 6-7, and here's Martin facing a pair of Howard Stones in 8. The weight is all good. Alberta draws into the 4-foot. One game tied at 3. Howard with hammer in 9, Alberta red. Just about on the pin, and watch where this yellow finishes up. Little bump, and once all the heads get out of the way here, it's actually too close to measure. After a whole bunch of eyeballing, the umpire says the point goes to, it'll be red. And Alberta, and they lead 4-3 coming home. So it came down to this in the 10th.
Needs to curl a mile.
Need to be at least second shot.
He's got nothing here. This has to
curl
sideways. Come
on, going to come up. He's talking to him. Is it going to come up? Come up, honey. Is it going to be? No, it will not.
Howard counts a pair and Alberta loses the 3-4 game. They were never at their best this week, and after all the losing, you knew Howard was due versus the old bear. Martin curls 85%, Morris just 81%, and Howard was actually only 76%, but he's the guy going to the semifinal. Martin will have to settle for the bronze game, which he's not at all fond of playing, especially after the disappointment of this afternoon. With more from London, here's Adam Cook.
Thank you very much, Meg. You could say Kevin Martin's last shot is emblematic of how this Brier has gone for Team Alberta. The rink grinded their way to a 9-2 record over the round robin, and the players say there were problems from the get-go, but the skip seems to be taking the loss better than his teammates.
If I make the last one, though, he needs to miss a half rock and stick it, so the odds are he would have made that one anyways, but that was a good game. Unfortunate. Hate to lose, but the way it goes.
And we had our chances early. We had them for 3 or 4 in the first end. We make, and it's ball game. And then they curled really good after that. And we just didn't get any more pressure on them. And me and Mark were really, really good all week. We weren't really good today. And our back end couldn't get her going.
When we won our two Briers, everybody was playing really well. And this year, it was different guys playing poorly at different times. And you know, like you can see it on TV, that gets frustrating because we're not used to that.
It's been a long time coming, as you know, and I thought it was a hell of a game. There was a lot of great shots made on both sides, and you know, we didn't get down after it looked like we were going to get a couple in the ninth, and you know, Kevin ended up getting a steal, and we thought, no, what do you do? Just keep coming at them, and proud of the boys.
So now Team Alberta drops into the newly introduced bronze medal game at the Brier, but Mark Kennedy says he's going home to be with his wife, Nicole, who is expected to give birth on Sunday.
I'm going to go home if I can go home. Find me, but I don't think they will. They've been really good about this whole situation. They understand what's going on. They'll do the right thing.
We'll try to act semi-professional and go through the motions for the CCA. It's a ridiculous thing that they're making us do that, but
Kevin Martin even suggested he may not skip in Sunday's bronze medal game.
Well, I don't know. We'll see who comes down to play us. You know, see what they want to do. Or I don't know. I'm not worried about that game. I was worried about this game.
Can we get up for a game like that?
No, we cannot get up for tomorrow's game.
So Team Martin, or a version of, will play in tomorrow's bronze medal game. And to find out who they'll face, back to Meg Storms with tonight's highlights of the semifinal.
Thanks, Adam. Newfoundland and Labrador versus Ontario in the semifinal. Tied at 6 in the 10th. Glenn Howard facing 2 Gushu Stones in the 8-foot. It's a clean hit and stick. And that's the game-winning single. Gushu is done. Sunday's Brier Final will be Howard versus Jeff Stoughton starting at 5:30.
The CTV Curling Report, sponsored by Horse Racing Alberta. Proud contributors to the Alberta Lottery Fund.
Oilers off tonight, but the U of A Bears were 60 minutes from clinching their 49th conference crown. Those poor Calgary Dinos were completely overmatched at Claire Drake tonight. Alberta shorthanded 55 seconds in. There goes Derek Ryan. The backhand beats Chris Lazaruk. And 5 minutes later, Lindsay Nielsen, he fires. It's tipped home by J.P. Sasquatch. 2-0 Bears. Dinos respond so quickly that we almost missed it. Joel Eisenkirch beats Curtis Mooka from long range. Now early in the second, Alex Rogers to Sean Ringrose on the doorstep. 3-1 Alberta. A minute later, Sasquatch back for more, backhander, and he puts Calgary down 4-1. Bears would add four more to a good old-fashioned rout. Johnny Lazo added a pair. Chad Klassen, 4 points, 8-1 the final. Next stop, CIS Nationals in Fredericton. Oil Kings facing the Saskatoon Blades tonight, hoping to finally clinch a playoff berth. The Blades are strong, and Stephen Elliott strikes first. Third period, Blades up 2-0. Marek Vedetsky and Josh Nichols, they work the D-man, and they get one more for the 4-0 win. However, Lethbridge lost tonight, so the Oil Kings are actually in the playoffs. Elsewhere, Ryan Nugent-Hopkins with 3 goals and 5 points in the Rebels' 5-0 win over Swift Current. Canucks visiting the Flames tonight. Pick it up in the second. The Flames get it in on the net, and they keep pressing. There was no whistle, and David Moss makes it 3-2 Flames. Dying seconds of the period. Canucks on the power play. Christian Ehrhoff fires from the point. Sedin is there, and he ties the game. Canucks go on to win it 4-3. Elsewhere, Montreal shut out Pittsburgh 3-0. Toronto beat Buffalo 4-3. The Devils stole the Islanders' soul 3-2 in OT. Atlanta downs Philly 5-4. Columbus beat out Carolina 3-2. Florida edged Tampa Bay 4-3. Detroit 5-3 over St. Louis. Nashville 4-2 over Colorado. And the Rangers beat out San Jose in a shootout 3-2. AJHL playoffs. Fort McMurray beat Bonnyville 4-3 in OT. They lead the series 3-2. And finally, the future of Ty Fields inside the boxing ring is very much in doubt. The 6'8" Edmonton-based heavyweight from Montana fighting in Las Vegas last night versus 6'7" Michael Grant.
There's a right hand, drops it right on his back.
And his head hit the canvas very hard.
Five.
He's in trouble.
Fields done in by a straight right to the beak. Only third loss of his career, but this will likely end any hopes of fighting for a title down the road.
That was a tough shot.
Oh,
there.
I feel bad for the guy. Yeah, very tough.
All right, thanks, Meg.
Thank you.